Hi everybody, I am Dr. Purushottam DN, Assistant Professor of Commerce. Let us begin with the session for Become the Semester course, subject entitled Indian Financial System and topic entitled SEBI and Monitoring the Stock Exchange. What is SEBI? Securities and Exchange Board of India is an apex body for overall development and regulation of the securities market. It was set up on April 12, 1988. To start with, the SEBI was set up as a non-statutory body. Later on, it became a statutory body under the Securities Exchange Board of India Act 1992. The Act entrusted SEBI with comprehensive power over particularly all the aspects of the capital market operation. The role of SEBI: to protect the interest of investors through proper education and guidance as they regard their investment in securities. For this, SEBI has made rules and regulations to be allowed by the financial intermediaries such as brokers, etc. SEBI looks after the complaints received from investors for fair settlements. It also issues booklets for the guidance and protection of small investors. To regulate the control of the business on the stock exchanges and other security markets. For this, SEBI keeps supervising on brokers, registration of the brokers and sub-broker is made compulsory and they are expected to follow certain rules and regulations. Effective control is also maintained by the SEBI on the working of stock exchanges. To make registration and to regulate the functions of the intermediaries such as stockbrokers, sub-brokers, share transfer agents, merchant bankers and other intermediaries operating on the securities market. In addition to the provide suitable training to intermediaries, this function is useful for healthy atmosphere on the stock exchange and for the protection of the small investors. To register and regulate the working of mutual funds including UTI, SEBI has made rules and regulations to be followed by the mutual funds. The purpose is to maintain the effective supervision on this operation and avoid the unfair and anti-investors activities. To promote self-regulatory organization of intermediaries, SEBI is given wide statutory powers. However, self-regulation is better than the external regulations. Here, the function of the SEBI is to encourage intermediaries to form their professional association and control undesirable activities of their members. SEBI can also use its power when required for the protection of small investors. To regulate mergers, takeover and acquisition of companies in order to protect the investors. For this, SEBI has issued suitable guidance so that such mergers and takeovers will not be at the cost of similar investors. Prohibit fraudulence under the unfair practice of the intermediaries operating on securities markets. SEBI is not for interfering in the normal working of these intermediaries. Its function is to regulate and control objectionable practices which may harm the investors and healthy growth of the capital market in the nation. To issue the guidance to companies regarding capital issues, separate guidance or prepare for first public issue of the new companies, for issue by the existing listed companies and for first public issue by the existing private companies. SEBI is expected to conduct the research and publish information useful to all market players. To conduct inspection, inquiries and audits of the stock exchange intermediaries and self-regulating organization and to take suitable remedial measures wherever necessary. This function is undertaken for orderly working of a stock exchange or intermediaries. To restrict insider trading activities through suitable measures, this function is useful for avoiding undesirable activities of brokers and securities scams. Functions of stock exchange: continuous and ready market for securities. Stock exchange provides a ready continuous market for purchase and sale of securities. It provides ready outlet for buying and selling of securities. Stock exchange also acts as an outlet or counter for the sale of listed securities. Next function is facilitates evaluation of securities. Stock exchange is useful for the evaluation of industrial securities. This enables investors to know the truth worth of their holdings at any time. Comparison of companies in the same industry is possible through stock exchange quotations. Number three is encourages capital formation. Stock exchange accelerates the process of capital formation. It creates the habit of saving, investing and risk taking among the investing class and converts their savings into profitable investment. It acts as an instrument of capital formation in addition to also acts as a channel for right investment. And next function is provide safety and security in dealings. Stock exchange provides safety, security and equity in dealings as transactions are conducted as per well-defined rules and regulations. The managing body of the exchange keeps control on the members. Fraudulent practices are also checked effectively due to the various rules and regulations. Stock exchange functions as the custodian of funds, genuine investors. Number five is regulates company management. Listed companies have to comply with the rules and regulation concerned stock exchange and work under the vigilance stock exchange authorities. Number six is facilitates public borrowing. Stock exchanges serves as a platform for marketing government securities. It enables government to raise public debt easily and quickly. Number seven, provides clearing house facilities. Stock exchanges provides a clearing house facilities to members. It settles the transactions among the members quickly and with ease. The members have to pay or receive only the net dues because of the clearing house facilities. Number eight is facilitates healthy speculation. Healthy speculation keeps the exchange activity. Normal speculation is not dangerous but provides more business to the exchange. However, excessive speculation is undesirable as it is dangerous to investors and the growth of corporate sector. Number nine is serves as economic barometers. Stock exchange indicates that state of health of companies and the national economy. It acts as a barometer of economic situation or conditions. Number 10 is facilitate bank lending. Bank easily knows the prices of quoted securities. They offer loans to customers against corporate securities. This gives the convenience to the owners of the securities. Services given by the stock exchanges to the investors. Stock exchanges provide the liquidity to investment in securities. An investor can sell this securities at any time because of the ready market provided by the stock exchange. Stock exchange provides easy market to corporate securities and it provides collateral values to securities. Stock exchange provides better value to the securities as collateral for a loan. This facilitates borrowing from a bank against securities on easy terms. And it offers opportunity to participate in the industrial growth. Stock exchange provides capital for industrial growth. It enables investors to participate in the industrial development of the country. And it estimates the growth of securities. Stock exchange provides the facilities of knowing the worth of investment due to quotations and reports published by the exchange. This type of the information guides investors as regards their future investments. They can purchase or sell securities as per price trends in the market. And it offers safety in the corporate investments. And investors can invest his surplus money in the listed securities with reasonable safety. The risk in such investment is reduced considerably due to the supervision of stock exchange authorities on listed companies. Moreover, securities are listed only when the stock exchange authorities are satisfied as regard legality and solvency of the company concerned. Such scrutiny avoids listing of the securities of unsound companies. And services given by stock exchanges to the companies. Wide market for securities. Stock exchange give the wide market for the listed securities and enables the companies to collect the capital for promotion, expansion and modernization purpose. It directly provides financial support to the companies. It creates goodwill and reputation. Stock exchange enhances the goodwill and the reputation of the companies whose securities are listed. Listing acts as a character certificate given to a company. It gives prestigious position to the company. Facilitates fair pricing of listing securities. The market price of listing securities tends to slightly higher in the relation earnings and Stock exchange enhance the goodwill and the reputation of the companies whose securities are listed. Listing acts as a character certificate given to a company. It gives prestigious position to the company. It facilitates fair pricing of listing securities. The market price of listing securities tends to slightly higher in the relation earnings and property values. It provides better response from investors. Listed securities get better response from the investors due to the safety and security. Listed of securities, a unique service which stock exchange offered to company, is moral support given to stable companies. It facilitates quick selling of securities. Stock exchange enables companies to sell their securities easily and quickly. This is natural as investors always prepare to invest money in listed securities. It brings economic development. Stock exchanges brings rapid economic development through mobilization of funds for productive purpose. This facilitates the process of economic growth. Thank you.